Hi everyone, welcome to HowFixit. In this video guide, I'm going to show you how to disassemble the laptop, clean it from dust, and replace thermal paste. To disassemble this laptop, you'll need the following tools: Phillips 1 screwdriver, anti-static brush, thermal grease, plastic opening tools, tweezers. I also recommend using a magnetic mat during the repair process, which is especially useful in the case of this laptop. Throughout the disassembly, keep track of each screw so you can put them back in the right places. This will help successfully reassemble your device. And don't worry about losing any of the screws. All of them will definitely remain on the magnetic mat. In the description, I left links where to buy all the necessary tools. Turn the laptop over and remove all the screws on the bottom cover. Use a plastic tool to open the laptop case. I recommend using a plastic tool so as not to damage the laptop case when opening it. Disconnect the battery cable from the motherboard. Now, let's begin removing the cooling system. Disconnect fan cables. Let's begin cleaning the cooling system from dust. Remove all dust from the heatsink and fan. Remove all screws on the cooling system. Pay attention to the order of removing the screws. I recommend unscrewing in the specified order. Now you can remove the cooling system by lifting up from the motherboard. Remove the old thermal paste from the CPU and GPU, as well as from the heatsink. If the thermal paste is very dry and difficult to remove, you can use isopropyl alcohol to wipe the paste. How to apply thermal grease. Apply a small amount of thermal paste to the CPU. Then, take a plastic tool and spread it evenly over the entire surface of the chip. If you still don't know which thermal paste to choose for your laptop, in the description, I left a link to a video where I test different thermal greases and choose the best one for the laptop. If your laptop is still overheating after cleaning and replacing the thermal grease, I recommend watching my video about the cooling pad for the laptop, or how to undervolt the CPU and GPU to reduce heat and increase laptop performance. All links can be found in the description. Now you can install the cooling system and tighten all the screws. Please note how I tighten the screws on the heatsink. It is necessary to tighten all the screws evenly on each side, with a few turns of each screw. If you tighten the screw immediately and completely, there is a chance that you may damage the processor chip. Well, that's all. You are on How Fix It, and see you guys next time.